So part seven on the CNC. Let's see, first of all, alignment. Always have a little extra steel left over. So where I'm at here is right here on the plan. And the plan has been changing as I go. So might even expect to see it change some more, but this is like a front view and I'm not there yet. This is a side view and I'm getting there. This piece is actually going to be omitted now because it was just meant to stabilize it from twists, but I realize it's better to use that metal to put on the outside right here. To when I double up its thickness, it will keep this from moving in and out, even in the slightest degree. So it'll make it extremely stout. And as far as rock in this direction, I've already got this, so that's going to be used right here to keep it from doing this. So we've got a lot of rigidity. Even though that's 3/16, it's still going to be fantastically rigid. So let's see. Extra steel, that's what keeps me vertical. This is just clamped on and tossed aside later. Let's see, to perfect the linear rails. I mount one over here, and then as I'm mounting one over there, I mount it using a piece of metal that is going to be just the right length. So I press it up against the rail over here, I grind it off, and I figure out, you know, what length it needs to be, and I make sure it's not something that's going to bend, and I'll use that to actually set the other one in perfect over there and then do the same thing over here, so that when I actually run this, it's going to show me that it's exactly the same horizontally. And then the vertical adjustments can be done by not welding either of these before I weld on a piece of angle iron and a nut, in which I will then put a bolt through that nut and use that to raise that up, because that's the low corner. And I raise that up until this gauge shows exactly the same as the other end. So really simple stuff. I no longer need the hoist in the shop, because at this point I can just use the floor jack to raise this up if I need to shim this and perfect the table leveling. So the last thing is the paint, and the paint was a big deal. I spent $40 on automotive high temperature engine enamel at O'Reilly's and deeply regret it. It's absolute garbage. So I ended up going to an industrial paint supply store, not an automotive, but an industrial paint supply store where they sell aircraft paint. So this stuff here is better than any aircraft paint. It's actually the best paint you can get probably on the planet. It'll get so hard that you can't scratch it, not easily anyway. So that's the hardener. I think this is just a can, so that's the actual paint label there. I don't know if that'll help you, but that's really just the color. It's the hardener that really makes the difference. So it's a 4-to-1 mix, and you got to mix it and use it right away. So this stuff requires a 0.8, just really a touch-up nozzle, because you're putting on some really thin layer paint here. And for just doing these metal parts I have, I'm not doing large surfaces. I'd rather use a small nozzle anyway. Otherwise, I'll have overspray like you wouldn't believe. So I'm going to have to cover up my T-slot table before I do this. And that means tape and newspaper. Anyway, that's all for now. Mike out.